Over the years, I've learned one thing you can count on. It's the incredible spirit of the American people. It seems to be part of our nature to be at our best when things are at their worst. Once again this week, ordinary people step forward in the midst of tragedy to do some very extraordinary things. Our Rick Siegel has the story.
Day by day, hour by hour, minute by minute, we're beginning to recognize the victims of this unthinkable tragedy. But amid the terror, anguish, and despair, it's human nature for us to search for the silver lining in the cloud of destruction that still hangs over New York City. We're desperately searching for something to replace the horrifying images we see when we close our eyes. In a tragedy such as this, we find that in our heroes.
All walks of life are coming down here. Construction workers and iron workers are coming down with picks, shovels, ropes. Just everybody wants to work.
A half mile of guys just in a row, passing buckets back and forth, just trying to get the rubble out of there.
It was an intense feeling when they said, you know, we got four or five people alive down there.
They found the firemen today.
Three guys.
One guy walked out. He didn't want to be helped. Everybody just roaring, yeah, you know, pumped us up, and everybody kept going.
Those guys are heroes. They were in there. They were in the original scene, you know, helping people out. They put their lives on the line, and thankfully they got them back.
Hundreds of New York rescue workers lost their lives in the terrorist attack. This firehouse, nicknamed Hell's Kitchen, lost 10 of its very own. These are just a few of the brave people who lost their lives running into the burning buildings while everybody else ran in the other direction. These are the faces of true heroes.
Thank you. Yes, all right. Thank you, buddy.
Well, walking up the street, you're greeted by people with food to take care of you and water, keep you hydrated so we can go back and do it again. Feels great to have all the support from everybody here. Everybody's out keeping us going. If it wasn't for these people like you guys and these people here, we wouldn't be able to do it.
People stand by with tons of food, cards, just setting a little shrine up in front of the firehouse. I mean, all night just stand by, you know, the gratitude, just, you know, giving us so much food and just, you know, hoping they can help in one way or another.
I've seen the worst stuff in my life the last day, and this is the most amazing act of human kindness I've ever seen.
So how do you define a hero? At a time like this, you don't have to.